If you're still hiring an expensive web agency and struggling to build a website yourself, you're doing it all wrong. AI can now build a professional website for you in minutes, faster, cheaper, and honestly better. Today I'm testing 4 AI website builders: Wix AI, Framer AI, Lovable, and 10Web. Wix and Framer have come up in many different reviews as some of the top ones. Lovable has been more up and coming, as well as 10Web. So I'm going to try those 4 and let's see which one delivers the best results with the least effort. Before we dive in, let me quickly introduce myself. My name is Remi Taffin. I'm a software engineer with 15 years of experience, and I'm on a mission to build an AI automation agency that helps businesses scale fast using automation and AI. And today I'm building the website for that agency from scratch in less than an hour. Don't worry, I will skip through all of the boring parts so that you only get to see the exciting parts. All of that is going to be using AI tools. Let's see which AI tool can do it best. Today, we're getting started with the AI agency website. So we want something professional. We want to build something out. So the first thing that I'm doing here is to actually ask ChatGPT, please give me a prompt to build an AI automation agency website. And then actually, as a second wave, I wanted to give it a bit more specific things around a growth partner model and really focusing on the customer growth journey rather than just implementing tools. And then it actually generated a really good prompt from there that I've copied into a Google Doc, made some minor edits, but as a whole, that saved me a lot of time. So first, we're going to start with Wix. I'm going to actually copy my prompt in here. I'm going to put that in Wix. I'm going to be using this domain, tenfoldgrowthpartner.com. This is a bit weird because it's asking me exactly things that I put in the prompt already. So I'm going to kind of reiterate everything I've said before. This one is actually interesting because it's asking me what's my history. All right, let's give it a shot. Let's generate the website. I'm excited to see what it's going to do for us. All right, it's generating some stuff. Seeing a lot of overlap in between some of these different buttons. A lot of AI generated images. Some animations as you scroll through it. Can't say I'm specifically wowed in here, but let's see if it can regenerate something different. So here's, it says it's going to try something more modern, the vibrant, playful design, shades of purple. I'm going to try again. It's kind of the same images again and again with just a different layout. This is kind of like a very basic, I would expect that from, you know, basic WordPress with some free template or something like that. I'm going to change the site theme a little bit. See if we could generate a new one completely. All right, so it's generated something here. I don't necessarily love it. It seems very, very basic. All right, so we're gonna try Framer, which will be a little bit different. So Framer is more of a drag and drop, create anything. You have a lot more flexibility there. What you can do is you can create some basic landing pages, portfolio, or whatever you might need. And then it will create things for you. So you could really, if you have an idea of exactly what you want, it will really do a good job there. But then also interestingly, it has some templates that you can browse that I've looked at right here. There's a few that are actually free, but some are also paid. So we can try one of those. I'll try the Atomic here. Looks a little techy in terms of, looks like I'm, you know, have a product that I'm selling or something, some app on the Apple Watch. That's what it looks like at least. But the design is really a good place to start. It's much better. It's responsive and you can see all the different images. It's a lot more full, right? And then there's a lot more going on. But then from there, you can really edit anything you need, which is the colors, the fonts. Yeah, it really comes down to really getting and finding the right template for you. And there's a lot of templates that are available here. I'll see if there's another one that we want to maybe use. And then there's one that's for AI automation agency template. So I want to take a look at this one. That one's definitely very interesting. Some call to actions, some good photos, some good design.
Okay, so you're going to tell me where's the AI and all that. So there's a bit of a secret thing that you need to find in here. You go into that button with the Framer logo, File, and then Generate Page. And that will actually show you the AI prompt that you're looking for. So if you go back to the prompt and paste what we've been pasting in other ones, let's see what it generates. All right, so that's what it generated. It's a little nerdy, let's say. Feels a bit hacker, if it was maybe a security company, but it's actually quite unique if you think about it. There is no prompt or sort of chat for me to be able to edit things directly, so that's not as natural as some other platforms out there. But still, I can edit the original prompt and it will update based on that. So I'm trying to actually put in the same prompt multiple times to see what's happening and see if it generates different results every time. It seems it is different every time. So this is actually a pretty good way to get started and have everything drag and drop. It seems it's a really good design overall. It's very different every time you generate it with the exact same prompt. So that could be good or bad. But this is definitely very interesting and pretty good, better than I expected, to be honest. So let's try Lovable next.
I will copy my prompt again into Lovable and let's see what Lovable can give us. The good thing with Lovable too is that it has access to Supabase, which is a database integration. So if you, for example, want people to be able to log in, if you want to be able to save some customer information, so more talking of a SaaS business, it can definitely do a great job there. You can also connect your code to GitHub. I'm using the free account here, which is really up to 5 different queries a day. All right, so it has generated some really interesting and very vibrant colors. I actually like the landing page here. It's missing, some images. It has really no images at all. There's also not a lot of information about what is being done. But I like the call to action at the end. I like how this button is also a call to action here. So I'm just asking for more images, a banner, hero banner at the top, and also just more content throughout. So it actually ran into some sort of error here, so I'm going to try and fix it. That happens sometimes. Now, so this is good. There's a lot more content in here, which is really interesting. It did add some background images in here.
I'm gonna ask to change the hero image here, actually.
Okay, that's better. That's definitely more professional here. Everything else looks like it stayed the same, so that's good. That button doesn't work. I guess I didn't give it any instructions on what to do, so that makes sense. I could always make it integrate with Make or something like that to automate the flow. But for now, I think this is pretty good. We can see how responsive it is. This is on phone. So we can connect to GitHub directly, so we can edit the code directly in there. There's no way to edit it live, but it has a lot of information here.
It's actually very good for our first draft. Let's give 10 web a shot.
10 Web has been coming up a lot in my research as well. They have two products actually. They have the Generate AI one, they have the migration from WordPress. So I'm gonna try the AI one. So I'm just gonna put consulting agency. Just doing the site structure for now. So it's asking me to pick a theme color. So that's picked just that navy brown one and then minimalistic, which is probably a bit more professional looking. All right, so it's generating everything for me. And we'll just wait it out. All right, that seems to be done. So let's give it a try and see what that looks like. Let's see the responsiveness. All right, so I've been playing around with TenWeb a little bit more. After over an hour, I was actually not able to get that far. A lot of it is WordPress specific. You have to know what you're doing. You need to click around and find the right place to update whatever. There's not a lot of prompting going on, so you really have to just find things in the UI. And I found the AI to actually not work really well. I've asked multiple times to actually have a background image as the banner. That's what I've tried to do with that image. It just keeps refusing to do it for me, and it doesn't actually do anything when I ask it. So a little disappointed. Even basic things like putting that button as part of that section, it's not able to do it for me. There's just a bunch of different weird things that have been a little disappointing. I think another thing is the overall look is a bit more old school, traditional website, and a little less perceived as innovative. So I've decided to give Lovable some more time, and just more time on the prompting, and just have a very clear, in the process, I'm also trying to figure out what I want in there, and with a bit more prompting, I was able to really get what I wanted out of Lovable. When with TenWeb, it was just a lot harder and a lot more manual. So I spent a lot more time with Lovable, and this is what we had before. And I was actually able to turn this into this website, which is a lot more, a bit more wow factor compared to what we had before and compared to TenWeb. I really like the colors, and if I scroll down, the whole thing is dark theme, just looks more forward thinking, a bit more innovation, you think, a bit more new, someone that's going to rock the boat, which is something that I'm trying to convey a bit more. So I really like this one. I've also asked to create a contact page, which I really liked. I just asked just generate more content that is more relevant and getting people excited about submitting the form. This is what I found. So I really like Lovable. Even if I compare just the two, one thing that I've really considered is the pricing as well, because with Lovable, the prompting itself is free up to a certain amount. I think you have 4 or 5 prompts every single day. So what I did is to actually ask in one prompt like 4 or 5 different questions to update multiple things, and it would do all of that, and then it would update things, and then at midnight UTC it resets, so you kind of start over and you do the same thing the next day, and little by little it over like a day or two, you really have a functional website and you can really do a lot from that. That's what I've been doing. I've really loved it. There are ways to integrate with Netlify, which will give the ability to fully host things for free and integrate that to custom domains and with HTTPS free as well. So I will definitely do that for the time being and definitely go the Lovable route. I've really, really enjoyed Lovable so far. Also thinking more long-term, how I want my website to evolve, going with TenWeb is gonna actually force me to every single time go UI-based, very manual. I'm gonna spend 2-3 hours to make changes in different sections and generate many images and text. Versus with Lovable, with 1 or 2 prompts, I will be able to get directly what I need, change the color scheme, add a new section, inspire yourself from this, right? Just very prompt base. Granted that TenWeb does have an alpha right now for AI prompt, it is not working well. So I do not recommend as of right now, on February 2025, it is not really a good experience. That said, with Lovable, it's been a really, really great experience. All right, so this is actually the final walkthrough. I've made some changes with the company name, so it's called 100-fold Growth now. But everything else is a bit similar. I've tweaked the prompt a little bit to make it more crisp and ready to go. This is what it looks like. This is more dark themed purple, as I asked for more innovative colors. I've changed some of the language, added Google Analytics in there. I've actually integrated it with Netlify, which is the way to have all of the site deployed automatically with just a few clicks. It was really easy for free to get that hosted, connected my domain with that, and in 15 minutes I had the whole thing plugged in. It is already working and the company website is ready to go. After testing all four, Lovable AI absolutely crushed it. The site looks stunning, the setup was so insanely fast, and the AI generated design actually felt really custom made. I feel like I have a very unique website right now. If you want your AI website in minutes, Lovable is definitely the way to go. Lovable was faster to set up, the most scalable, the most professional, and really closest to what I was looking for. Most customizable, really, in minutes, and every time I needed something, a new page or something, everything would be very easy to get. And the whole building and hosting will be entirely free, so that is a no-brainer compared to 10web's very expensive pricing. Let me know, which AI website builder do you think is the best? Let me know in the comments, and if you want to see more AI automation in action, don't forget to like, subscribe, and turn on notifications. I'll see you in the next one.